All right, here is the video review for Ocular Max TERRAEGIS, I believe his name is, their version of Trailbreaker. You can see he's a nice black truck with a little detailing, rubber tires, which is cool. And you should look at, look at the tread pattern on the tires. They're actually really pretty cool looking tires, but they are rubber, they can come right off. You can go back on, he rolls very well. Anyway, sorry. But yeah, he's a truck. He does come with several accessories. He does come with these little things which you can plug in onto the top of the vehicle mode here if you wish. There's a couple little peg holes there to do so. Somebody was asking or was saying that you probably plug them in underneath there. I haven't been able to make that happen. There's just not quite enough room underneath there to plug these in and kind of fill those holes from the bottom. But you can see how, like, if you plug this into the top, it's going to kind of bump against that leg and everything inside there. But you can put those on the vehicle mode if you wish. It does have blue headlights. A lot of people were worried. They kind of look like eyes. Ooh, I'm happy. But yeah, clean underneath. And that's pretty much vehicle mode there. Oh, my watch wants me to breathe. Anyway, so to transform them, we're going to start here. We're going to lift up this rear piece right here. Pull these little bits out to the side just enough that we'll untab this little tab that holds the top part on. Go away, Nat. And then this whole assembly, once you get that untabbed, this whole assembly can lift up and out. You can kind of slide this forward a little bit so that's free. Then you can lift that whole rear assembly up. And untab this right here. You can see his face hiding there inside the car. I got everything with this. I want to point this out. The instructions say you will get an extra set of these side view mirrors because they are very thin. Like, this one's already at one point bent back on me. I was able to bend it back into place. They do have some detailing there on the inside to make them look like rear view mirrors. They are fragile, but you will get a replacement set. I haven't had any problems with it aside from the one that bent, that they haven't broken yet. But you do want to be careful with these side view mirrors. But anyway, enough about that. So bring this off, and then we're going to unpeg from right up here on the front. This whole assembly will come loose like that. And then again, pull this out a little bit, untab these pieces from the front. The wheels actually push up for robot mode. Slide up in their thing, and when you're going back to truck mode, you do want to make sure to you pull them down, and then you actually have to push them till they click. They will click and lock into place so they don't go up and down. If you don't lock them, they're just gonna do that, and that's no good for a car. So make sure you lock them into place. But pop all the wheels up, bring these down. You can see here's his legs. You kind of bring them down like this at the knee. Untab this part from here. You can fold the runners up on the side, which will give it the clearance for everything to flip around here. You want to open up this little tab here on the leg. Yeah, go this way. Open that up, because that's going to come around when we get this off. This piece needs to flip up. Unpeg the foot here. Flip this piece up. Fold this in. You kind of want to rotate. Flip this over so that the wheel ends up inside the leg. And then before you fold this all the way down, you want to bring this down a little bit, rotate this whole panel around, and then make sure you keep folding that side rail in, because that does, and it doesn't stick out on the side like some of the promo shots made it look. It does fold into the leg there. And you bring it down, and then push this down like this, and this should tab in right here. Also, as you're folding this around, you want to fold the side view mirror to the inside there. It stores inside the leg. But you get it all lined up, tab it together. Why are you not lining up here, leg? There we go. Get that in, that will tab in to the side of the leg right there. And then this piece with the gray and the silver slides over to fill in the leg this way. I should clip it a little better than that. And then flip the foot forward. down. And we're gonna do the same on this side. Bring that down, bring the whole leg around, and tap this. Make sure that side mirror folds in there. Lift this up, fold the wheel in, bring this down and around with this folding inside there. Bring the whole leg down, tab it together, slide that piece over, and bring the leg down and around. And there you've got 2 feet. This piece folds down, just like that. I'll lift it up here to get to the top part of this here. Unpeg the arms, bring them down. Pull them out to the side here. If they're attached to these windows, you can fold the windows in like that. Bring this whole assembly down. You can see here's the spine piece, you slide that up. And then here, unpeg this centerpiece from the hood, fold it up, and then that allows these two side pieces to collapse in like that. And you can fold this whole thing down and around to the front. Bring the arms around. It snaps on there, and the windshield collapses down a little bit, and then tabs into the front of the chest there like that. And at this point, you just flip his head up, lift this up, lift that up, flip his head up, fold this panel up here, and this panel comes up, sits there on his back, so that folding down, which makes his waist swivel, and there he is in robot mode. We haven't pulled his hands out yet, and I'm only doing that because the shoulder weapons, you can pull the back off, the back part of this comes off, flip that up. And you get these clips. They can go on either arm. Just plug this onto here. There's two little clips here that go on the top and bottom. You can clip that onto his hand and give him that little arm weapon. The hands. Like you just pull a, if you can get a finger under one of the fingers and you just pull the arm straight out, or the hand straight out. And he does have posable fingers. He's got a ball joint thumb. All the fingers are individually posed. They're curved, and the index finger does have a joint there for it to move as well. But there he is, more or less in robot mode. He's got a few accessories. You've got his force field generator piece. It's on a ball joint up here. And on this particular connector, this allows it to peg right back here on the back of his head. Like that. And then these pieces, you get two of these. If you fold this up, there's a little divot in the middle of it. I don't know how well that's showing up. And these shoulder cannons, you can see there's a little clip here. All this black, it's kind of hard to show us off. But you take this, you kind of slide it in from the front so the hook on the back goes into the back of this piece. And then snap it into place. And then it can levitate, you know, not levitate, but angle up and down. So you can do that. You can do one on each side. Have them, give them two hands and put one on each side for more of a classic look. If you want, you can take this off, take this clip and flip it all the way back, which opens up a port right here. You can take this off and attach it to the other adapter, which is square on one end. And you can plug this on in over here onto his other shoulder. You can just plug right in there. You can have that array on his shoulder as well. So you've got some options in how to customize it. Now he does come, the one minor issue with this, and this may be fixed on the final, is he comes with these little clips right here that are designed to hold, if you're not using these on the back of the weapon, they're designed to hold these and then plug into the square hole on his shoulder. You see right there. Which they kind of do. It will sit there and for just display, that's fine, but it really doesn't lock in very well. the clip likes to pop out very easily. So if this bit right here were just a smidge longer, it would hold a lot better. It's not horrible. It will stay as long as you're not bumping it around, but I wouldn't take this and, like, you know, carry it somewhere unless you've got those things stored somewhere, because they don't like to stay in. And I still feel like this should be going in deeper, even with the clip there on the back sticking out of it. I still feel like this should go in better over here. But it's rocking for some reason, and maybe it is just that clip. I don't know. But you can see it likes to fall out. This side especially. But again, that may be a quality thing that will stop, you know, that will get fixed by the time that he's out. Okay, he's got a ball joint head. Very cool. This thing can rock back and forth. It's got the ball joint up here, so you can angle this however you want. This can angle up and down. Dual hinge shoulders. A little bit of a crunch there. He does have a bicep swivel. Hinge elbow. And a lot of people were complaining about the elbow being just that pin. I forgot to extend the arms. There we go. And I haven't had any issues with that being a problem. It's not in any danger of cracking just from regular movement. But, you know, some people have an issue with that. And visually, I get it. Physically, I don't think you're going to have any problem with that hinge pin. It's very solid. But same on both arms. Like I said, the individually posed fingers. Why is it so hot in this kitchen? I don't know if you can tell, but I'm sweating. Back and forth on the hips. He does have a waist swivel right there. He does have a thigh swivel. Hinge knee, ankle tilt. And you got some posability front and back on the legs. So yeah, pretty posable dude. I like him, he's pretty cool. Here's a quick size comparison with Masterpiece Ironhide. So you can tell he's one of the bigger robots. He fits in with the right scale of figures if you want to put him on your Masterpiece shelf. And here they are both with Sphinx, who is much shorter. So yeah, I haven't had a chance to check out Bad Cubes yet, so I can't validly say this one's better or worse than that one. It does seem to be less complicated. But yeah, it's a good solid Trailbreaker. Another good release from the Ocular Max line. TERRAEGIS.